warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome to another episode of 5 Minutes with Imam. As usual, we have Sheikh Mohamed Ali. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. How is the day? Good?
Alhamdulillah.
Good, alhamdulillah. I know you're a very busy man, but thank you for coming, for filming.
Thank you so much.
You spend quite a bit of time in the masjid, and also Musallis come to the masjid. Mm-hmm. Now, what should be the relationship with the masjid, and what is the etiquette they should follow when they come to the masjid? What should they do? Mm-hmm. Can you elaborate more on this, please?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, as-salatu was-salamu ala Sayyidina Muhammad al-Nabi al-Ummi al-Kareem wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa al-tabi'een wa ba'd. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إنما يعمر مساجد الله من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر وأقام الصلاة وآتى الزكاة ولم يخش إلا الله فعسى أولئك أن يكونوا من المهتدين. Which means the masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are only to be maintained by those who believe in Allah and the last day and establish salah and pay zakah or give zakah and do not fear except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Right.
For it is expected that those who are on the true guidance.
Yes.
Subhanallah.
Right.
And even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Qudsi hadith,
yes,
Buyuti fil ard al masajid. My house is on earth,
yes,
are the masajid.
Right.
When we go to the masjid every day to pray, and we know that we are going to visit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his masjid.
Right.
Subhanallah.
Right.
Imagine when I come or someone comes to your house.
Right.
What should he do? He should respect you, respect your house.
Yes.
He shouldn't make noise or something like this.
Okay.
Exactly, and more than this, we should do in the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Right.
Because
right.
We are going to pray, we are going to do any act of ibadah.
Right.
Okay, we are going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Right.
That means we should respect that place.
Right.
The house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
That's right.
We have some etiquettes. One of them,
yes,
we shouldn't eat or drink something has bad smell or strong smell like onion, garlic or something like this before we go to the masjid.
Right.
Especially when we have a big gathering like Friday, like Eid, like something like this.
Yes, yes.
Subhanallah, imagine when you sit on someone next to you and you keep reading.
I can't concentrate on my prayer,
yes,
I tell you.
Yes.
I can't concentrate.
Yes, yes, we shouldn't do that.
That's right.
You can eat it or drink it like... we have enough time before we go to the masjid, like at least 2-3 hours before we go to the masjid.
Yes. Okay. I remember this hadith that Rasulullah said, don't go to the masjid if you are eating garlic.
Yes.
Oh, that's right.
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
Yes. When we go to the masjid, from the etiquettes of the masjid, we should enter the masjid with our right foot.
That's right.
Okay.
Yes.
And say the dua that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say. He used to say, Bismillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Allahumma ghafir li dhunubi waftah li abwaab rahmatik, which means in the name of Allah,
right,
peace and the blessings upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Yes.
O Allah, forgive me my sins,
yes,
and open for me the doors of your mercy.
That's right.
Very,
yes,
very, very beautiful dua, subhanAllah.
Yes.
Okay, you ask Allah to forgive you.
Yes.
You ask Allah to open the doors of his mercy to you.
Yes.
And even you send the salah and salam upon Prophet Muhammad
sallallahu alayhi
wa sallam. You do that every time when you go to, when you enter the masjid.
Right.
Okay,
right.
In any salah.
Yes.
Okay, we should do that.
Yes.
And also, when we are in the masjid,
right,
we shouldn't pass in front of any praying person.
Right.
If someone praying, for example, sunnah, two rak'ah,
yes,
and we enter the masjid, we shouldn't go in front of him.
Right.
Should, like, keep enough space.
That's right.
Okay,
that's
between, it's like, just to respect him, not to distract him, or just he's focusing or something like this.
Right, right.
We should keep space time between him and between...
Sheikh, just for understanding, how much space has to be away? 1 meter?
Just to make his sujood.
So let's say sujood here, so...
Yes. And even from the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi
wa sallam,
when you pray in the masjid, you should put something in front of you.
That's right.
If someone want to pass, he can pass after that.
That's right, that's right.
Okay?
Right.
Or you can come behind one of the pillars of the masjid and pray.
Yes.
Okay?
Right, right.
If someone want to pass, he will not pass between you and just a half meter or something
You're
like this. Okay, yes. Even you can put your mobile phone, you can put anything just in front of you to tell people don't pass from that area.
Okay.
You can pass after that.
That's right. Okay. That's right. Yes.
This is one of the etiquettes of the masjid. Inshallah, we'll continue in the next video.
Inshallah. Okay. Jazakallah khairan, Imam. So you heard it. You heard it from the Imam, the etiquettes. We'll continue more with it in our next episode. So thank you for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.